Good morning, Saints.
Good morning.
Black History Month is observed annually in the United States, Canada, and the United Kingdom to recognize and celebrate the contributions and accomplishments of Blacks or African Americans. It is celebrated in February in the United States and Canada, and in October in the United Kingdom. Black History Month started as Negro History Week and was created in 1926 by Carter G. Woodson and the Association of the Study of Negro Life and History. Woodson was a noted African-American scholar, historian, educator, and publisher. The second week in February was chosen because it coincided with the birthdays of Abraham Lincoln, February 12th, and Frederick Douglass, February 14th. Those were dates the Black community has celebrated since the early 19th century. The primary emphasis of Negro History Week was to encourage the coordinated teaching of the history of Black Americans in public schools. It gained the support of the Departments of Education in the states North Carolina, Delaware, and West Virginia, and the city school administrations in Baltimore and Washington, D.C. Despite the lukewarm response, Woodson considered it one of the most fortunate steps taken by the association, and plans were made to continue it as an annual event. Woodson believed that teaching Black history was essential to the physical and intellectual survival of the race and our broader society. He is quoted as saying, "If a race has no history, it has no worthwhile tradition. It becomes a negligible factor in the thought of the world, and it stands in danger of being exterminated. The American Indian left no continuous record. He did not appreciate the value of tradition. And where is he today? The Hebrew keenly appreciated the value of tradition, as is attested by the Bible itself. In spite of worldwide persecution, therefore, he is a great factor in our civilization." The expansion of Black History Week to Black History Month was first proposed by the leaders of the Black United Students at Kent State University in February 1969. The first celebration of the Black History Month took place at Kent State 1 year later in February 1970. In 1976, as part of the United States Bicentennial, the informal expansion of Negro History Week to Black History Month was officially recognized by the U.S. government. President Gerald Ford spoke in regards to this, urging Americans to seize the opportunity to honor the too often neglected accomplishments of Black Americans in every area of endeavor throughout our history. Today, many people question the relevance of continuing to celebrate Black History Month. We have made many great strides as a people, but remembering our past is still important. Let's watch as the Mayfield family answers the question, why Black History Month?
Gifts from Daddy.
I do like getting gifts from Daddy, but also because of Black History Month.
Really? You like Black History Month better than you like getting gifts from me?
Of course not. But I like Black History Month because it's cool.
What's so cool about it? I get tired of learning about slavery over and over again. We're not slaves anymore.
No, we're not slaves anymore. But it's always good to know about where we've been so we know where we're going.
I don't get it. What does that mean, Dad?
It's good that we learn about our ancestors so we can learn from the lives and the lessons that they tried to teach us.
Our ancestors were stolen from their land. They were beaten and forced to work the land. They were sold and separated from like to live.
But despite all of that, we learned the language of our owners. We even came up with codes so they wouldn't understand us. Like the old spirituals that we used to sing, like Wade in the Water.
Wade in the Water.
And Swing Low, Sweet Chariot.
Swing Low, Sweet Chariot.
Those were code songs that they used to tell the slaves where to be at and how to escape.
Those songs really helped slaves run away?
They sure did. Like Wade in the Water. It was a code to tell the slaves to walk along the riverbank so the dogs couldn't pick up on their scents. We still sing those songs today, not for the spiritual meaning, but to remember the sacrifices that our ancestors made before us.
There's also another modern tradition that derived from slavery called watch night service.
Huh? I thought we go to watch night service to praise God for the New Year's.
We do go to watch night service for that, but we also, it derived from the Emancipation Proclamation. The Emancipation Proclamation derived on September 22nd, 1862. It didn't go into effect until January the 1st of 1863. And then our first watch night service was December 31st of 1862, where the slavery watched for the emancipation to free slaves.
Wow, I didn't know that.
Here's something else I bet you didn't know. Not all slaves were freed at the signing of the Emancipation Proclamation. The slaves in Galveston, Texas didn't get free for 2 years later. It was General Gordon Granger who came to Texas and took over the state in 1865. The General Order Number 3 was signed on June 19, 1865. We celebrate that holiday as the Juneteenth.
That's horrible. Those slaves were still working and didn't know they were free.
It was horrible, Rachel, but slavery tasted even sweeter because of that.
Wow, our ancestors went through a lot. I can't wait to learn more about slavery and how they survived.
Me too. If they can survive, we can too.
And that's why I love Black History Month. Our ancestors and other contributors paved the way for us. Mm-hmm.
But we also should know that we don't just celebrate Black History in February, but we need to celebrate it all year long.
I think February is one of my favorite months now.
Mine too. I can't wait to tell the kids at school about slave songs, watch night service, and Juneteenth.
I'm glad to remind us of family.
So wait, does that mean I don't have to buy Valentine's Day gifts?
I don't even think about it.